I got into hospital by ambulance. It was the morning and I remember lying there and actually looking at my family, just out at my family and doctors and nurses and just doing all this stuff around me. That's basically what I remember. They did explain to me that I'd had a stroke and that I needed to go for some testing. Ben had just realised that it wasn't dissolving quickly enough and it wasn't happening enough. So he decided that I had to be rushed to Melbourne, that I had to go to Melbourne.
This type of software is based on CT scanning, and we use the CT scan to allow us to make decisions on whether patients are appropriate to receive acute therapies for acute ischemic stroke. The software itself utilises a technique we call CT perfusion, and basically that involves us taking a CT and injecting an iodine-based dye into the patient's vein. Through a computerised method, the software creates images that allow us to see whether we're able to provide these treatments in a safe, timely fashion to improve the patient's outcome after a stroke. And the beauty of the latest software is that it actually gives us really rapid outputs of the perfusion imaging that we need, and we get that within a matter of a couple of minutes of the scan being taken. In addition to seeing it on the computer screen, we can also receive it on our iPhones, so if we're remote to the hospital, we're able to review that and give advice over the phone so that we're not delaying the institution of treatment that a patient needs. This type of software allows us to make the types of decisions that people would be making in Melbourne, at the Royal Melbourne Hospital, in New York, in London, in large centres. Without this type of software, we really would struggle to make the right decisions about who the right patients are to be sending to Melbourne, and so to have this is a real advantage.
Ben made that decision. He made that really quick decision that, right, you've got to go to Melbourne, and I will always be really grateful towards all the staff there, all the nurses, all the specialists. I'll be forever grateful that he made that decision. I honestly believe that if it wasn't for the quick thinking of all the nurses and the doctors and the equipment that they do use, that I honestly don't think I would be where I am today. I don't think I would be where I was 72 hours after it happened. It's just incredible. From where I was, not being able to comprehend, not being able to speak, not being able to walk, not being able to lift my arm, to probably 48 hours, 72 hours later, to actually being out of bed and in the shower and being able to walk around. It's just been incredible. Just incredible.